Hello friends, welcome to the series on predictive techniques. In this series of videos, we will be discussing various concepts and principles of systems approach to interpreting horoscopes. And you can always refer to our website, yournetastrologer.com, for detailed explanations, examples, and various other learning resources. The links to the resources are shared in the description box. Remembering Lord Ganesha, let's begin the series. In the previous video, we learned how to analyze a horoscope in 3 minutes. Now we will apply those concepts in a step-by-step manner on a practical chart. Let's start. So in step one, we prepare the horoscope with the help of a suitable software. It can be Jyotish Tools, which is a very good software for systems approach astrologers. So we fill in the details and the chart comes up like this. Then in step two, we identify the functional nature. Here the functional malefic planets are Rahu, Ketu, Mars and Venus, and they are shown in red. And out of these, Venus is the most malefic planet, or MMP. And most benefic planet out of the functional benefics is planet Saturn, as it is the lord of 4th house. Now, what is the most effective point of the chart? This is a very important thing, as the MEP is 13 degree 46 minutes. So it becomes the MEP of all the houses of the chart. Now let's move to step three. In step three, we analyze the strength and weaknesses and mutual relationship of planets. Here we see that Jupiter, the lord of second house, is placed in the ascendant and is very strong and placed very close to the most effective point. So it aspects 5th, 7th and 9th houses positively. Mercury is placed in combustion, and Sun, Saturn and Mercury, all these three planets suffer from the bad placement in the 6th house. Now we see which planets are debilitated. So Saturn in Aries and Moon in Scorpio are debilitated planets. Planet Sun, though exalted in Aries, but it is weak due to being in infancy and placement. Now planets Saturn, Moon, Venus and Mars, all these planets are in the old age. And since only one planet, Jupiter, is fully strong, so all planets except Mars suffer from the weakness due to dispositor weakness also. When we analyze the afflictions, we find that planet Moon is afflicted by fifth aspect of Ketu, and planet Ketu itself is afflicted by the 8th aspect of Mars. So the auspicious conjunction we have seen of Jupiter to the MEP, and Saturn is the weakest planet in this chart. So now we move to step four. We see the chart in totality along with the transit chart. And let's first analyze the dasha periods. So here, main period of Mars and sub-period of Saturn is running. So in the natal chart, Mars is placed in the second house. It is a lord of 6th house, a malefic planet. It is placed in the second house. And Saturn, the sub-period lord, is a benefic planet, but it is very weak and placed in the 6th house, which is house of conflicts. Now let's see how these planets are faring in transit. In transit, Saturn is placed in the 3rd house. And if we go back a few weeks, it was stationary at 1 degree in infancy for quite a long time. So In transit, the sub-period load is running weak. And the main period load, Mars is placed in the fifth house and it is under the affliction of Ketu. So it was also at prolonged placement in this house and it was hovering around 24, 25 degrees. So next we move on to analysis of transit. So here there are three dimensions. Transit to natal chart analysis, transit to transit analysis, and natal to transit analysis. Let's see this graphically. The triple transit analysis of this chart on a particular date is analyzed like this. So first we see the red arrows. Red arrows show the influences within the transit chart. So it is transit to transit analysis. Like here, Ketu afflicts Mars and Venus is placed close to the most effective point. So Venus from the house of losses is afflicting the MEP of sixth house, which is the house of conflicts. And now we see transit to natal. So in transit, Ketu is placed in Scorpio at 25 and in natal chart, it is afflicting natal moon with a conjunction, close conjunction. And it is afflicting natal position, its own natal position also. So we see that the nodes are stationary in transit and they are stationary around the their natal degree only. So that is a very difficult time for the native when transit nodes and natal nodes are at same degree and stationary. So this is how we synthesize the impact of sub-period load and triple transit analysis. So let's move to next slide. Now we see how the longevity parameters fare in the chart. There are various factors which are to be analyzed for longevity. So these are the factors. And let's see in the chart how they match up. So first and the foremost thing, there is no empty sign rising in the ascendant, no empty sign rising in the eighth house, and no empty sign is rising in the ascendant of D8, the Ashtamsa. So that is a good thing because when the empty sign is rising, then the strength of that planet is to be seen. So now when there is no empty sign, so we move to other factors. Other factors are factors ruling health and factor and the planet ruling 12th house. So here we see that 12th lord is not afflicted and is well placed in the 4th house. And it is away from MEP. So it is not causing any affliction in the chart. And the planet ruling diseases is placed in the 2nd house. And the lord of 2nd house is Jupiter, which is strong. And Mars is also placed away from MEP. So it is a good placement for the sixth lord. But it is causing some affliction to Ketu. So it can give some problems in its sub-period. And if we analyze the Ashtamsa, we find that it is occupied by two planets. The ascendant is occupied by two planets, Mars and Jupiter. So Mars is second lord and Jupiter is 10th lord. So it is a good thing that both benefics are occupying the ascendant of D8. So that is a very happy thing and it supports longevity. And another good part of the Ashtamsa is that 6th, 8th and 12th houses are unoccupied. So they are vacant. So no planet is weak due to bad placement. So that's a positive for longevity. Then we move, when we have analyzed all the things piece by piece, so now we synthesize all the results and see how we advise the person. So we saw that in this chart, main cause of challenges in life is the placement of three planets in his house of conflicts. So conflicts play a vital role as you saw that lot of 10th house, lot of 11th house and lot of 4th house all are placed in 6th house. So profession, income, sources of income and mental peace are all connected to the house of conflicts and challenges. And why this chart came up at this point of time for consultation? So that is answered by the transit. Transit analysis tells you the immediate need of the person. So here current issues were inflamed by mutual affliction of transit and natal nodes. And as we saw, transit nodes were stationary. And Ketu was afflicting natal moon also. So these three factors contributed to his current problems. And the Lord of Conflicts, which is sixth Lord Mars, was also stationary under the transit Ketu. So he had to face multiple setbacks in profession, and the setbacks were so grave that he had to seek redressal from various forums in his department. And when he could not find success, he ultimately decided to move court of law against his own employer. So he was advised the remedies performance for the functional malefic planets, that is Mars, Venus, Rahu and Ketu. And he was also advised to strengthen his benefic planets, especially Saturn, Sun, Mercury and Moon, by a special power kavach to get success in the matters of litigation. Because Saturn is placed in sixth house, is the weakest planet of the chart. So success in litigations is ensured only with strengthening of Saturn and Sun and regular performance of the remedial measures. So this is how we synthesize the analysis and advise the person. Thank you. Hope you understood the concepts well. We will meet soon with more videos in this series. Till then, be happy, be healthy, stay blessed, and keep learning.